Today we'll study chapter 2 about the polynomials. So first see one question. If I write ax plus b, see, this is the degree, this is the coefficient. So degree is 1, we call it linear polynomial. Okay, then suppose I write ax square bx plus c. Highest degree is 2. This is called quadratic polynomial. Then I write ax cube bx plus c bx square cx plus d. This is called cubic polynomial. But when I write ax to the power 3 by 2 bx plus c, not a polynomial. Then what is called a polynomial? An algebraic expression of the type a 0 x to the power 1 or x to the power 0, a 1 x to the power 1, a 2 x to the power 2, like this, is called a polynomial. When the degree of the variable is positive integer. Positive integer free from radical sign. So let's discuss in detail what does it mean. If I write a x square or 2x square 3x plus 5, the highest degree you find is 2, here also degree is 1, which is not negative. This is a quadratic polynomial. This is a quadratic polynomial. But if I write 2x to the power minus 1 plus x plus 3, the degree is negative, so not a polynomial. But if you are right, or minus 2 suppose you write, that is much better. Power should not be negative, not a polynomial. Again I write root 2x square plus 3x plus 5. Constant coefficient is a number, constant number root over, but it makes it polynomial because you have to check the power of variable. You have to check the power of variable. This is a polynomial. But if you write two x to the power half plus x plus 5, because the degree is fraction, free from radical signs, should not be negative, should not be fraction, not a polynomial. Okay. Then zeros of the polynomial. Zeros of the polynomial. Zero of the polynomial means if you are right. Zeros means that is the values of x. How many values of x we can have? 1, 2x power 1 plus 3. The degree is 1. It has 1 zeros. 1 0. 1 0. 0 doesn't mean the value is 0. 1 0 means 1 value of x. If I write two x square plus 3x plus 1, suppose, then 2. The degree is 2, means x, if you solve it, you will get two values of x. So, two values of x means it has two zeros. Similarly, if I write x cube 4x square 5x plus 6. So highest degree is 3 means it will have 3 zeros. Okay. But today we will discuss about quadratic polynomial. So we will discuss about quadratic polynomial. The quadratic polynomial means, look at the polynomial of the type ax square plus bx plus c, means the highest degree is 2, which is not fraction, which is not negative, is called quadratic polynomial. Okay. So, find question first. Find zeros of the polynomials from the graph. Suppose how many zeros it has, look at. Zeros means how many places is cutting the x axis, not y axis. If this is your y axis, it is cutting at two places. So it has two zeros. If I take one more this is your y-axis, this is your x-axis, it's cutting at one place, two places, three places. So it has three zeros. Because you always have to check, is cutting your x-axis in how many places. So again you see, suppose I take one more. How many zeros it has? It is cutting y-axis, not x-axis. So, no zeros. Means no village of x. No zeros. Okay. Then, you can check it here. Cutting y-axis at two places, x-axis at one places, you can get one zeros. So, zeros means is cutting your x-axis at how many places. So, this is the graphical method to find the zeros or x value of the polynomial. Okay. Now, how to solve it? Suppose we have a question, find the zeros of the polynomial, of the following polynomials. Suppose I got x square minus 3x plus 2. Okay. You have studied in class 9 how to factorize it. Factorize means splitting the middle term. So how to split? Now product 1 into 2. Product is 1 into 2, that is 2. Your sum is minus 3. Product ka factor find out karo. 2 is 2 ones are 2. That means this 3 I can write x square minus 2 and 1 means 2x plus 1x. 3 means 2 and 1 so 2x plus 1x plus 2. Now open the bracket. X square minus 2x minus plus minus 1x plus 2. Grouping method. Make one group here, take x common, x minus 2 minus 1 common, x minus 2. So that gives you x minus 2, x minus 2 I have taken common. So when you take minus common, the plus becomes minus. You have to notice it very carefully. Because minus into minus is plus. So from where, from plus when you take minus common, it remains minus. So now x minus 2 common, what is left out? X minus 1. Now for zeros, put x minus 2, x minus 1 equals to 0. Implies x minus 2 is 0 or x minus 1 is 0. So what do you get? Implies x equals to 2 will go here 2 and x equals to 1 will go here 1. That means x has 2 values, so 2 zeros of the polynomial. Let's take one more question. 2x square minus 4x plus 2. 2x square minus 4x plus 2. So, what is your product? 2 into 2. X square ka coefficient and constant. 2 into 2, that is 4. That is 4. Product is 2 into 2, which is 4. Okay? Then sum is minus 4. Now find product ko factor. 4 ka factor. 2 ja. So how to make it 4? Now 2 plus 2. 2 plus 2 is 4. So that is 2x square minus 2x. 4x will be minus will be outside. 2x plus 2x. Then plus 2. Then what do you get? Open the bracket. 2x square minus 2x. Minus plus minus 2x. Then plus 2. So 2x square. Look at what is common here from these two. 2x common. Here is 2x gone. Only 1x. From here 2x gone. So 1. From here minus 2 common. If first term is minus, you take minus common. Then this will be x. From plus, if you take minus, then it is minus 1. X minus 1, 2x minus 2. The x minus 1 common, 2x minus 2. So for zeros, put x minus 1 equals to 0. 2x minus 2 equals to 0 implies x equals to 1. Here 2x equals to 2 implies x is equal to 2 by 2, that is 1. Therefore x is equal to 1, x is 1. So repeated zeros here, this is called repeated zeros. Okay, let's take another question. Suppose x square plus 7x plus 12. X square plus 7x plus 12. So what to do? Then you have to write splitting middle term. 1 into 12. Product is 1 into 12, that is 12. Sum is 7. This is sum, middle term. So 12 of factor. 2, 6. 2, 3. Now you can check. 3, 1. So 3, 1 is 3. 2, 2 is 4. 4 and 3. 4 plus 3 is 7. 4 into 3 is 12. So 7x will write x square plus 4x plus 3x plus 12. Now plus sign, open the bracket. No change of sign. X square plus 4x plus 3x plus 12. X square plus 4x plus 3x plus 12. Now take out x common. So x plus 4 plus 3 common. If you take 3 common, it is x plus 4. So what I did is x plus 4 common, because x plus 4 is common. Then what is left out? X plus 3. So implies for zeros, put x plus 4 equals to 0. X plus 3 equals to 0 implies x is equal to 4 will go that side, minus 4, 3 will go that side, minus 3. So these are the zeros. Okay, what we'll do is we'll take another tab. Another tab means x square minus 7x. There is no 3 terms here, only 2 terms. How to solve? Now you take common here. This type of question, first you take common. What is common? So x common, here will be x, here x you have taken out, minus 7. So you got two factors, one is x, one is this. So 4 zeros, put x equals to 0, means first one equals to 0, second one equals to 0. So x is equal to 0 already have got, then here x is equal to 7. So 2 values you got here. Because the degree is 2 means you will have 2 values. Take another question. (2u) square minus 8u. So 2 terms, if there is common, you will take common. From 2 and 8, 2 common, because 2 is dividing both. 2, u square and u, you take u common. So what you get here? 2u square, 2u gone, u is here. 8u, 2 is gone, that means 2, 4 is 8. 2, 4 is 8 and u have taken, so u minus 4. U minus 4. So for zeros, 2u equals to 0, u minus 4 equals to 0. So how to solve? Then you will get, implies multiplication into division, u equals to 0 by 2, therefore u equals to 0 by any number is 0. Here minus will be that side, plus u equals to, you can write 0 plus 4 or 4, u equals to 4. So 2 zeros you got. Another type question, look at this question and this question. Suppose x square minus 8, x square minus 8, here u in both, here only x here, no x here. So what do you do? You have to write x square minus 8, write 4 zeros, put x square minus 8 equals to 0, x square minus 8 equals to 0 implies x square equals to minus, it will go that side, 0 plus 8 implies x square equals to 8. X square means 2 values. How to get 2 values? Now x equals to plus minus, 1 will be plus value, 1 will be minus value, root over of 8. So 8 ko factor find out, 2 2 2, 2 4 is 2. So root over of 8 means 8 ka root over means 2 2 2. You have to make it pair, 1, 2 comes out, root 2. That means this value is 2 root 2. So, implies x equals to plus minus 2 root 2. So, which are the zeros? Now, x is 2 root 2 and x is equal to minus 2 root 2. One is plus value, other one is minus. Take one more example. One more you see. Suppose I write 4x square minus 8. See, x square coefficient is here, no x here. So same method. 4 zeros, put 4x square minus 8 equals to 0. First you have to remove this 4. How to remove? Now first you write 4x square equals to 8 will go that side, 0 plus 8 implies 4x square equals to 8. First you have to make it 3 now. How to break? Multiplication will be division. X square equals to 8 by 4. Cancel here 2. X square equals to 2. Then x will have 2 values. What are 2 values? Now plus minus root over of 2. Therefore x is equal to plus root 2, y is equal to minus root 2. So like this you solve exercise 2.1 and 2.2. Tomorrow we will study new questions.